Wasn't gonna be good. Hey, everybody. Sure, I'm ready for this. Oh, my game sound is really low. I need to fix that too. I forgot that I was doing other things and I have it way turned down. So I will fix that momentarily. Because I just realized it's like barely being picked up. Is that better? I don't know why my microphone is being silly, if it is. But is the game sound better? I'm low. Is that better? Mm-hmm. had to turn up the game because I know it was low. I turned it down before. But I don't know if I got any better. Did I get better? My whole computer is like jacked lately. Oh, shit. I'm going to turn down the sound in my headset though. Ha! Because that shouldn't affect you. I don't think. That's just too many things I have to remember. That's funny, though. Better. That's not who I'm going to talk to. Thanks.
Oh, dumb cards. Sweet.
Yeah, and unfortunately, I can't do anything from my end unless I log it, like, open up the web browser and go through a whole bunch of rigmarole. And I don't have any mods on. I mean, considering it's just Robert. And I'm sure he's not watching. Excuse me, sorry. Sorry, chat. That came out of nowhere. Thank you. I have a feeling he's like a bad guy. I don't know. It's kind of weird. He just gave off weird bad guy vibes.
Oh, things are going well. I've been running into a bit of trouble with those giant bugs.
Oh, Salt Tree. Hallowed spirit of my line. Through my weakness, the glorious House of Ul has all but disappeared beneath the sands. For want of the strength to raise it up again, it were better that it fall.
Okay.
Forgive me, but I know not what else to do.
Hey, everyone. How's it going?
Safety, babe. Okay. Ugh, I'm not ready. Chat, I'm not ready.
You needn't trouble yourself so.
Your grace is most kind, but it is no trouble to
okay.
me. Rather an honor.
I will ignore you.
If your grace is ready, I shall summon the Warrior of Light.
I am.
Everyone looks to be in high spirits.
With good cause.
A common victory may serve to unite even the most unlikely of allies. You've brought us one step closer to a united Eorzea.
Your modesty knows no bounds, antecedent.
I don't know what this means, though.
As I'm sure you've gathered from the town ears. Yeah, it's not as nicotine. It hasn't been blood. Could be plain. Could be this plan might actually
Were it
work.
Not for your efforts,
okay.
Anyway, Sir Emmerich would never have become such a steadfast ally.
Keep up the work. Keep on the work.
When he convinces his countrymen to rejoin the Alliance, we shall all reap the benefits, military and economic. I tell you, we are on the cusp of a new era of unity and prosperity. Territorial disputes are all that divide us now. But I have faith that we will find an amicable solution in time. And failing that, I'll have my warrior of light box the ears of all concerned. Speaking of whom?
She will be joining us shortly. A matter at the quicksand required her attention.
Oh, they made off of the bay without springing the traps. Looks like they come up in here again. I half expected it all to happen. That's why.
All the things.
I'm sorry, I just got to miss that part. Looks like you both. You and the Joker would be the best of my world. The Joker told me this is the first time I've been outwitted by Joker. I got more traps designed in the works. And I plan to test them out soon. Stop by again if you like Joker. Since you're already stuck up and quit with some people, you know, maybe willing to lend them my hand? Seems they talk to you and the trouble's rarely enough. Okay, so travel.
Enter.
Where am I at?
Your grace.
So I only got one, two,
your guest has arrived.
Story ones.
Pray, come in, and take your ease.
We're waiting for Barney. The chuckle was not going to catch us up. Oh, wait, before I forget, There's a special mission made out of these mushrooms.
It's well that the steps of faith held against the Horde.
The chuckle were aimed at the nav.
And what of the city proper?
Out, which means plenty of hunters that...
We sustained some few losses, but the heart of our nation yet beats with vigor. I am not certain I could say the same had we not received your most generous aid.
An attack on Ishgard is an attack on the realm. We stand together or fall divided.
We'll go right up through the banner snatch territory. That's why we got to the
such noble words.
Oh, just turn lightly when they're coming back. Let me juggle up here. Let's slide the greens and steps and drops. Once everything's set up, let's meet at the hunter's camp to the north.
I had hoped to speak in the presence of Her Grace, but it seems she has been delayed. That being the case, now would seem as good a time as any. Honored friends.
He totally does.
Pray allow me to convey Ishgard's warmest gratitude for your part in the defense of our lands. Tis upon the success of this very alliance that my recommendation to throw open the gates of judgment shall be founded. With the blessing of the Archbishop, it is my hope that Ishgard will soon be reunited with her long-estranged sister nations, and that Eorzea shall once more be as one.
Very well.
Is Artemis?
Nothing to worry about. I shall return anon. You wished a word, Yu Hase?
I knew I could count on you, partner. I hope you didn't taste any, because I put a little something extra in my gas screen's sleeping powder. Once that chocobo falls from my trap, it'll fall in deep sleep, genius. It was a chocobo cry. It was over in the search of a trap. Let's go, partner.
You may go. Your grace.
Can you believe it? It's a genuine, bona fide, drownsified chocobo. See, hunting's easy.
You must be curious as to the reason for this private audience. The matter I would discuss, however, will soon make apparent the need for discretion.
Would you go and tell Libra that I'm a real hunter now?
I intend to abdicate the throne and dissolve the monarchy.
No one ever really found out what happened to her, but they knew deep down in their souls.
You have seen for yourself the storm of turmoil that howls through our streets. The government fails in its responsibilities, and my subjects suffer the consequences of our incompetence. But I will see them suffer no longer. The victory feast shall provide the stage on which I declare the dissolution of the Sultanate. 'Tis mine intent that the ruling class of our golden city should take its place beside the common man in a fair and equitable republic. No more shall this nation bow to the whims of a privileged few.
God's dear.
Yet, that which I propose will entail the tearing up of this city's very foundations. And even Roban, with all his strength and influence, will be hard-pressed to keep his footing on such treacherous ground. Thus would I ask you to lend him a steadying hand. You who have endured the wrath of innumerable foes are the one hero in whom I can place my trust.
Seriously, I can't hop back.
Will you do this thing for me? I am truly grateful. More grateful than I can well express. Much of my dread for the coming days has been quieted.
Your Grace!
To be fair, though, that's the birds perfectly capable of fending for themselves. They only felt afraid to the Vendersons just because they were trapped. For that, I feel bloody awful.
Her Grace! The Sultana!
is dead.
How you doing over there?
Poison? In her wine?
Something, made you sad?
You!
Yes!
You did this!
What made you sad?
She's dead.
Oh, the Salt Knight?
Spare us your denials! I see no other suspects, and the room has but the one entrance.
Those poor little eyes as they bugged out of their head.
I hereby accuse you of regicide! Men, arrest this viper!
Just one possibility. She's in heat. I have a mind to go and verify
my
suspicion.
Barring a few exceptions, we have detained all those with allegiance to the Scions. The Rising Stones is also under our control.
Would you mind going? Here, let me your map. I'll mark the place where I caught the bird. Chances are there's a nest nearby. If you find it, know what's inside and come back to tell me.
And what do you hope to achieve with this mutiny? Why, that which we have striven for all along, Commander. The salvation of Eorzea.
The bird or the hunter? Just as I thought, this one's about to be the mother. There's no help in it, and then as fine as the bird she is, she's gotta go back to her nest.
Knights from the homeland, this cannot bode well.
It's a rule of ours, you see. You can't.
Lord Commander, we have received an urgent message from the
no
Holy Sea.
The first specimen you've ever seen.
I am grieved to report that your serpentine foes have resumed their assault. Needless to say, your presence is urgently required. These knights have come to bear you swiftly home to Ishgard.
A surprise attack.
We've had no such word from our men, and the timing is most fortuitous to catch us away from the city.
Most fortuitous indeed.
Hey, big birds. Beep, beep. Coming through.
Lord Commander, we must away.
I'm not sure I can make this jump. I did.
You have been a most gracious host. I hope that I might one day return the favor. Come, Lucia.
See? That's what happened. She race changed. They instantly turned on her. Try to warn her. Anything's wrist. Oh, that's actually pretty nice looking. God damn it, did I take any more of these other sets?
Whatever is going on in there? The ever dutiful brass blades. I must apologize, but my dance card is rather full. Another time, perhaps?
Thancred of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn. You stand accused of committing acts of espionage in service to the Garlean Empire.
Espionage? What in the seven hells are you talking about? Ah,
If you're referring to that business with the Ultima weapon, then you must understand. I wasn't myself.
Under interrogation, an Imperial prisoner revealed your involvement in numerous dealings with the enemy. We've also been investigating reports that you are a practitioner of forbidden arts.
You
best come along with us.
Oh my god.
You invite me to your party, and now you want me to leave? I do so detest receiving mixed signals.
He wants four.
Come then. I believe I've lost my appetite for this farce of a celebration.
Do you march armed soldiers into a royal banquet and eject state visitors without her grace's consent? You treat the brass blades as your personal army and show contempt for the throne with your every act. Leave us now.
Is that an order, General? Mayhap you have mistaken me for one of your flames. You will find I am not so slavishly obedient. As you lecture me on personal armies! As for your outrageous claim that I have shown contempt for the throne, let all here observe that it was not I who feasted while an assassin removed its occupant. I expect this is your idea of defending the nation, is it? This and diluting our forces through these distractions in Cartano and Curthus. I do begin to see how the ranks of the Immortal Flames came to be riddled with Garlean sympathizers. You are plainly unfit for command.
I take it the police were that easy? They're quite a bug killer.
Wait, Constable. Your words make no sense. What assassin?
Thanks to you, we'll be able to sleep peacefully for a while.
You mean to say you don't know?
Right.
We caught the vaunted champion of the Scions in her grace's private chambers, not moments after the deed was done.
No! No, this cannot be!
Save your breath! You will need it to plead your case. You and your entire order are to be tried for this atrocity. Bring in the prisoner!
You don't say. Itala actually bagged the bird. I ain't never seen a hunter get a kokobo on their first outing. I guess what they say about Mikote is true. Can't leave me on the unsung hero about this bit of praise either. If things keep going the way they
this
are,
woman stands accused of poisoning her royal majesty, Nanamu Ulnamo, and as suspected accessories to the crime, all members of the Scions of the Seventh Dawn will be detained for questioning.
Oh, shit. How do they look? Check.
This is madness!
What a pity. Who'd have thought your tale would end like this?
Should you demand further proof, a vial with traces of the substance used to poison Her Grace was found upon the assassin's person.
How very convenient.
You would speak of convenience? Who persuaded Her Grace to host this celebration? A diversion which presented you and your confederates ample opportunity to commit the crime, and a crime in which to fade from view. A more convenient occasion I could scarcely imagine.
How dare you? After all we have done for Uldar.
Hold your tongue, witch. I'll not be ensorcelled. I know all about the dark gift that you and your disciples wield. Oh, yes. I've observed how you worked upon the minds of the Alliance leaders, bending them to your will. And what of your cordial relationship with Sir Emmerich? For years, Ishgard abjured all contact with the outside world, and now the Lord Commander of the Temple Knights treats you with the familiarity of a childhood friend. I'll tell you what I think. I think this desperate defense of Ishgard was but a ruse to deceive us into dividing our forces. Your next move will be to charm your Kirthan allies into invading our lands! Now, that is truly ridiculous!
How do you even think of this stuff?
She cannot be dead.
As I feared, the road ahead is teeming with Nath soldiers. Marchamp did not exaggerate that.
Stand aside, Ilbert. I want to see the Sultana.
They would threaten the dragons openly. Do you intend to
spare yourself the pain, brother? I saw her with my own eyes.
Mighty though.
For a mercy, the poison took her swiftly. Her handmaiden can attest to that.
There is no route save the one before us. Should the beastmen offer battle, we have no choice but to accept. Yeah, whatever. I don't give a crap. Let's do this. Get this MSQ going.
This cannot be.
Oh, man. You've already given me chopped, huh?
Nanamo. No!
Plainly, the Royalists can no longer be relied upon to keep our nation safe. And so it falls to the Monitorists of the Syndicate to govern Uldar. But should you wish to help us, General, we would be more than happy to entrust the task of planning Her Grace's funeral to you. It seems only right that you should bury your precious Sultana, and we will be glad to be rid of that burden.
I'll bet you will. You more than any man.
Whatever do you mean?
I mean you had her killed, you black-hearted bastard!
What rot! Though I did have sufficient motive, 'tis true. That young lady caused me no end of grief. She always was a most unwilling puppet. I dare say Her Grace was grateful that someone thought to cut her strings.
Wow.
I take no pleasure in killing the Nath. This was to avoid
you
bloodshed.
Would
that
mock
I
her. Then mock her from hell!
Courtyard together with the Nath. You keep your lands on your back, Dracoon. On my word, it was a little bit of a shit start.
Have you lost your mind, General? It is forbidden to draw steel in the royal chambers, much less slaughter our fellow syndicate members. You're one of them. You've been in league with the Scions all along.
You're next to scheming bastard.
Ravon!
Seven hells!
Thank you for joining us.
Admiral, we must leave.
How unlike you, old friend. I did not expect to take your arm so easily.
Take the Scions into custody. They have conspired to commit regicide. And arrest this traitor as well.
Gilbert, I hope you choke on their coin.
Tis better than the dirt I've supped on these long years. We can't all abandon Alamigo and become great war heroes as you have. You are not the man you once were, Ravon. Since that girl strapped the yoke around your neck, you've become docile. She took the mad bull and cut off his balls. And a bull that cannot rot is fit for naught but slaughter.
Wow.
Shall I tell you who really killed your precious Sultana? It was me.
For a moment, but there is more to this than I yet understand. Flee this place. Clear your names. Find out who is behind this plot. It is the only way. Now go!
Truly brought forth their deity from the ether, we must face it together.
Ah, there you are.
Watch our hopes fall apart. All now rests upon the promise.
Thancred, where have you
but
been?
If we think of confronting it, we must first study its origins.
Avoiding the fumbling advances of some very persistent admirers.
Sustains its existence.
When I realized the celebrations had turned sour, it seemed prudent to slip away and take stock of the situation.
And consult with Merchant. He knows more than that.
T'would appear that much of the city is already under tight guard. It occurs to me that expanding the Brass Blade's authority may not have been such a wonderful idea after all.
The success of this plan was contingent upon those thugs having the run of the place. Just how long has this scheme been in motion?
The careful preparations, the maneuvering of forces. I am inclined to agree with the General's insistence that a deeper plot exists here.
So, would I be right in thinking we now have an excuse to pummel as many brass blades as we like?
Unless you plan on pummeling them all, I'm not sure that will greatly aid our cause.
The Sultana's assassination was but one part of the scheme. We two were its targets. And though we did not share poor Nanamo's fate, we are yet hobbled by the charges laid at our door. Where now might we seek refuge?
Where indeed, we may safely assume that our foe is thought to have the Rising Stones watched.
Forgive me for stating the obvious, but our choice of destination will matter little if we cannot secure an escape route out of Ulda. Happily, I believe I can provide one. Papa Shan once told me about the passages hidden in the walls of the palace. If I recall correctly, the fireplace in Nanamo's chambers conceals the entrance to a tunnel. It should lead outside the city and allow us to avoid any messy confrontations.
Oh, back already, are we? Ah, I met the nap, did you? And what is it you like to do? I like to kill their god. Jesus Christ. They summon a primal?
The rest of you, go on ahead. I'll handle this lot.
I don't know bugger about that.
Okay. By yourself?
Beyond their trading habits, they never seem much point in asking.
I suppose I shall just have to join you.
I'm a barter with a small hive to the north and west of here. Outcasts are the main tribe, from what I understand. I reckon they've been one of the
crystal braves, too, huh? Now this should be interesting.
That sounds promising. Exactly
Ida! Papa Limo!
No right incentives. But seeing as you're in a hurry, you might want to divide the chores amongst yourselves.
We will hold our pursuers here. Hurry, now. Find this tunnel of Thancred's.
Calum tree fruit, and always in that favorite, a generous portion of young Naka flesh. I shall gather the fruit. Leaping to the lower branches of these
Minfilia, we cannot linger.
Should present a little challenge to me. Then I shall collect the nectar. With Master Alfie's arcane assistance. Ah, that leaves you to bring home the meat. They'll need you to carve it from the small nakas that live in the rivers. Three big hunks should do enough, I reckon. Once you've got everything together, you'll need to sit down. Set it down at what we call the trading post. Here, I'll mark it on your map. You've been most kind, Master Marchomp. Well then, let us attend to our respective tasks and reconvene at the trading post. I need hardly add that the last one here there is a rotten naka egg. Alfie, you are no longer allowed to make jokes. Yeah, Midsgard, I know she was conveniently quiet when we talked to the big-ass freaking dragon. Yes.
That got me. Almost like a jump
scare. Now look what you've done!
Ida, are you all right? There are just too many of them.
I'm fine. I could do this all day. How about you?
Nearing the end of my tether.
There'd be a way out if I could fly.
That's a lot of them to deal with.
This is so stupid! We're the Scions of the Seventh Dawn! The ones who stand between this realm and the evil that's trying to destroy it!
And if you think we'll leave the stewardship of Eorzea to the likes of your masters, then you're sorely mistaken.
Sorry I dragged you into this, Papa Limo.
Tis hardly the first time, and I'll be damned if it will be the last.
Oh, this is not good. But I have a phone call.
I never knew such a watercourse existed beneath Uldar.
The architecture is of the Sildine style, if I'm not mistaken. The ancients plainly foresaw the need for a ready means of escape.
This way!
Sorry about that. Of course it was my brother. Oh, and of course he's calling me back, because why not? Okay. Sorry about that. That was my brother, of course.
Well, that didn't take long. It seems these tunnels were not as secret as I hoped.
You two go on ahead. Thancred and I will deal with this.
What do you mean to do?
Dragons are fierce and terrible adversaries.
Only that which is required to ensure that the dawn's light survive to brighten the morrow.
Shadows passed over the group, the ground, but no longer.
Fear not, antecedent. You haven't seen the last of these fair features.
My friends.
Thus did the one mind decide to heed the words of the black-robed men. The one mind would call forth our god and unleash his blades.
Leave
upon
us!
Upon the dragons. Dravinian lands would become Nathlands, and even larger would grow our domain. But our god ever hungers. The price he demands is crystals. Far exceeds the rewards for this war. We of the Vaf despise and revile.
What is the plan, milady? Shall I take the dozen on the left and you the dozen on the right? The odds are not exactly stacked in our favor.
Numbers will count for little when I bring the tunnel down upon their heads. Though I relish the thought of being in tune with you for all eternity.
You wound me. I will have you know that many a maid would kill for the chance to spend forever at my side.
No, oh, thank you.
May I have the last dance?
Oh my god. Did you see that on stream?
This is going splendidly. Now would be a good
we
time, milady.
Our weapons stopped.
It is done.
I would make the
forgive me, Mitra.
So the guy wants four, now this one wants two. Delicious meat nearby. There is much delicious fruit nearby. We rarely want for food. What we want for is shelter.
Heidelin.
Building materials.
She speaks to me.
Are one thing we cannot hunt. We have no materials. We cannot repair our homes. We cannot build new structures.
I must remain behind. But you cannot stay with me.
To repair our homes. There is much Dravinian clay at the Gnath Isle.
Please, you must go on.
Fetch some there.
You are the warrior of light. You are hope for the Scions and for all the realm.
Come.
As long as your flame continues to burn, the light of the dawn may ever be relit. You must escape and save Eorzea from those who would plunge it into darkness.
Fraud, delicious fraud. The mere thought of it makes our mandibles itch.
Tis the only way.
Do you know the high ground near Mare's Oath? A great tree grows there. Its fruit delicious. The ripest fruit fall to the ground, ready to be eaten. Please fetch us three of these fruits. Why do you love the fruit so much? Generous hunter, we would like to ask something of you. It is not difficult work. We need naga eggs. Five delicious naga eggs. Slay a Nikki, naga, and harvest its delicious eggs for us. We wonder, will you never tire of naga eggs? Sivorot.
I am glad to see you safe, my friend. What of the others? Damn that man!
I call upon the powers of a primal.
Taleji played me for a fool! I thought the crystal brave's mind till the very moment I felt the blade at my back.
I reasoned that it was necessary evil, and willingly shoulder the burden of
there will be ample time for soul searching later. For now, we must put some moms between us and Ulda.
But you must surely see that I am aware of the magnitude of the transgression. Not so for them. They saw their duty for no greater purpose than to expand their dominion. To a scion of the Seventh Dawn.
Well, would you look who it is? Need a ride? I doubt it'll be half as exciting as the last trip we took. Not if I have anything to say about it anyway.
Unleashing the power of the 12 in an attempt to prevent the calamity. Thus, while I may not condone your actions, I at least understand it now. Not so the matter. And as you so well put it,
let's not dawdle, eh? All aboard!
I can only conclude that they
at least Alfie's okay.
Of the ruinous consequence to the gods and satiable appetite. The longer those primates suffer to exist, the greater the suffering they will cause. They must be destroyed. A being of whom we know not. Has it occurred to you that you may be sending the warrior of Pinto's death? No, I. Einstein, it would seem it is I who did pursue it too much. Pray forgive me, Zavrax. I do not fear my people. Wait.
I was stocking up on supplies over in Vesper Bay, you see, when your sister came up and begged a favor. Said her brother was having some trouble down in Ulda, and likely needed a helping hand to get in away.
Ha. Do you truly imagine yourself a second?
I think in them ruins would make a fine hiding place. I decided to try there first. And lo and behold, there you were.
We know not where the god resides, or how to challenge
him. Judging
unless
by them soldiers as we're pouring out of the city, I arrived not a moment too soon. Must have been fate that we happened to find you there, though, eh?
I learned how best to secure an audience with the demon. In this, at least I may.
I had thought to look after Alize, but it would appear she was the one watching over me. I've made such a mess of things.
The young lord certainly appears eager to prove his worth. Yeah, trust me. I know what's your best. Oh my god,
who might you be, young sir?
How is this even possible? We are Vath. We are the non-mind. We do not hear the
Pippin Talpin, Vice Marshal of the
we
Immortal Flames.
Their will.
I had been on the Alamegan front these past few moons, but an urgent communication called me back to Uldah.
Put this idea from your mind.
Scarce had my boots touched the cobbles, though, when the streets erupted with cries of assassination. I immediately went in search of answers, and came across Master Alfino here. Needless to say, I did not think his imprisonment justified. The blame plainly lies with the monetarists. Their greed and corruption are well known to me, but for them to take advantage of the situation with such alacrity...
Was that Pippin, you said? Ain't that the name of General Alden's lad?
Yes, I am his son. Adopted, of course. 'Twas only as we were leaving Uldah that I learned her father's fate. Once I have seen you a safe distance away, I mean to return to the city and extricate him from this madness.
But you needn't travel no further than Blackbrush. Our fugitives have a friend waiting for him there.
I dreamed of bringing about Eorzea's salvation, but in the end,
by my side at all times.
It was I who needed saving.
Do not even flinch, but I need you. Okay, we got Idiot Stein, Ice Heart. Alfie's over there with the vendor. Oh, there's a vendor. Hello, I mean, please. What do you have? Oh. Things of upgrades. Oh, but I can buy the whole set. Oh, hold up. Try on.
I mean, it was kind of, like what I didn't expect some of the things to happen, obviously. I had a feeling, and I said this yesterday, was that when I streamed, that something was fishy with Alfie's crew. Like, it just, I didn't think that they were fitting right. So the fact that they were kind of a big part of it was, I don't know, almost felt expected, I guess. I think the saddest part for me was when the Sultana was killed like that. Just, I did not see her dying. That was not at all where I thought that was going. And then, yeah, see, and I feel like I didn't even catch that, I guess, like, I don't know, I didn't suspect him in the slightest, I just felt like the rest of, like, it was just kind of, like, the whole thing was just kind of weird, like, it didn't make much sense, like, Alfie tried, but, so, yeah, that was very, you know, very interesting. Like, he didn't really seem like, I wouldn't have put him as, like, the head of the betrayal, in a sense, to me, like, but... Oh, so long as we're free. Okay, well, you know. Oh.
Ah, you've come at the perfect time.
Sid.
I've designed a new trap for That sure is snare even the cleverest of us. And I need someone to help me with the final step. Do you know the cave south of here? Rare glowing mushrooms called lampshades glow there? And they are essentially my trap. Could you fetch me one while I work on finishing the budget?
And I was really, really glad that, obviously, Sir... I can't even think of what his name is from Ishgard.
Amaric.
He's my favorite, so...
Sir Amaric,
yeah. He's my favorite, and I'm really glad that he was okay.
He's
my favorite. I was fangirling over his voice when he was talking. Yeah.
I've already got some people on the job, but the slimy buggers multiply faster than you can kill them. At the moment, we're short.
Oh, see, and I guess I didn't. I kind
of
missed that.
Go there quick as you can and use this here solution to blow the slugs out. I reckon that you know what to do after that.
I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure I can put two and two together, champ.
Like, honestly, I can't wait.
Throw salt on them. Check. Yeah, we're not doing movies. Hey, Mr. Mender. Mr. Mender, mend my ship.
Your airship awaits. Okay.
Oh, Nico says Sir Daddy Amaric.
Sir Daddy. Of course there's no rest for the righteous. There's no rest for the weary either.
Okay, I'm in town. Alright, I am gonna get off for tonight. It's been a shit day. Thank you guys for hanging with me, and hopefully we'll get some more of the MSQ done tomorrow.
Oh, I did forget that. Oh. That just hits a little harder then. Okay. Thank you. I wasn't thinking because they never really talk about it. Yeah, that's for sure. I was not realizing that that was what his name, last name is.
There has been word from the capital. Ishgard has weathered another assault, and 'tis said several wyverns broke through into the city proper. The temple knights succeeded in slaying the beasts, but the intrusion prompted orders to further strengthen the guard and to place the city under a perpetual state of alert. How keenly we feel the loss of our wards at the gates of judgment. Yet we must not bemoan our misfortune. Sir Emmerich is safely returned from Uldar, and once more leads the defense of Ishgard. As for the matter of your asylum, I am afraid no progress will be made until the threat to our nation is diminished. But do not despair. You are not without allies. You are more than welcome to shelter here for as long as you wish. Pray, think of it as a new headquarters of sorts. The Falling Snows, or some such. All frivolity aside, any who come here in search of you will receive no aid from House Fortong. For once, the Ishgardian reputation for inhospitality shall work in our favor. Agents of Uldar will find their every inquiry dismissed, and their every request for entry rebuffed, until such time as their masters have acknowledged your innocence. You once fought to preserve the honor of my dear friend. Tis a blessing that I may now repay that debt kind. But let us dwell no more on this. Pray, join the rest of your companions. Tis bitterly cold this day. I suspect there are those who might welcome the warmth your presence brings.
Oh, it's not voice. Oh, don't cry. Yeah. Oh, gotcha.
Is all my doing.
Oh, poor Elfie.
I believed myself the only one who truly understood Eorzea's woes. And look what that arrogance has wrought. I gave commands, influenced governments with my certainty. I treated the Crystal Braves and even the Scions themselves as pawns in my great scheme to save the realm. But in my headlong rush into imagined glory, I paid no heed to the ground upon which I trod. The salvation of Eorzea. What was it that I hoped to achieve? Did I believe that I could rid the realm of every danger and difficulty? That I could defeat the Empire and the Ascians, and find homes for every refugee? Oh, yes. I was so very clever. Become a guardian of Eorzea, I implored, and sat back to watch my perfect army cleanse the land of chaos. It was all but a means to feed my own vanity.
Well, I mean, day late and a dollar short there, Elfie. Hindsight's
20/20. Only when all is lost do I finally realize the truth.
Oh, Elfie, no.
Right.
So, Master Alfino, are you content to remain a broken blade? Is there no flame hot enough to reforge you? What of the fine companions who yet stand at your side? I dare say the fires of their determination will soon have you slicing the air again with your customary wit.
I hardly deserve such friendship. And besides, where are we to go?
Alfino, if I may?
Aww.
Should this place not serve our purpose, then we shall go to Ishgard. Minfilia told me many times, as long as we stand fast against despair, the beacon of hope will never be lost to sight. Be it in the snow or in the clouds, we few will see that the dawn's light shines again.
You are right, Totaru. Thank you. And thank you for your kind words, Lord Orshvon. Tis true that Eorzea yet has her guardians.
Oh, really?
The Scions have achieved much, and 'twould be remiss of me to discard it all in a fit of self-pity. Let us then resume our journey, together, one step at a time.
Look, it's the credits. Aww. Yes.
All has been arranged as you desired, my lord.
can't. His voice is so annoying. Right. Definitely not. I don't know that I have necessarily. Oh, I did? Oh, cool. I like titles.
Dawn's light will shine again. So long as we have these specious accusations hanging over us, we will struggle to achieve anything.
Okay.
You must go to Ishgard, as Tataru proposed. I will return to Uldar and set things right.
Pray, do not be so hasty, Master Elfino.
Lord Orshifon.
Full well do I understand your desire to clear your name, but now is not the time for drastic action. You yet have allies upon whom you can rely. There is no need to act alone.
Yes. Yes, of course. Pray forgive my impatience.
I bring tidings. Count Edmont has decreed that the three of you be taken in as wards of House Fortan. Under our patronage, you shall be granted access to the city proper. Pray. Consider our manor your new headquarters, from which you may gather info. Needless to say, should any of your missing allies be found, as I am certain they shall, they will of course be welcome to join you there.
You are more than generous, my friend.
The Count is a good man, and just.
To Ishgard, then. There we shall carry on the Scion's legacy.
Here!
So are you saying that I should log out now and watch it? Is it like, yes. This one? Or is this not it?
do. Enjoyed the whole story of it. I thought that they did a really good job, like, bringing it into the culmination of where it was at. I am very tired, though. It's been a very, very long day. Tuesdays are very rough with therapy for my boy, so it might be a little tough. I was trying to get to Ishgard, though, because I know you're there waiting for me. Sure where I have to go, but I guess not too far. Because I are tired. It's been a very emotional day. Or emotional ending to it this day. But I agree. Is there not a smile? I feel like I wish that there was one. But there isn't one. Which is really weird. There needs to be one. I'll just say that. Oh, see, no, like you had it, but I can't. I don't know. I don't know. Yes. Proceed, please. Oh. Gotcha.
And so they came, at a friend's behest.
Elfie's wearing a coat. But I'm not.
Heroes once celebrated as saviors of Eorzea, brought low through treachery, their names blackened with royal blood. With memories of the lost and dreams of redemption, with hope yet in their hearts, they came.
Because it does look kind of.
To Ishgard, shining city on the mount, overlooking the dominion of Kurthus. A great and proud nation, devoted to Helone the Fury, ruled by Thordin the Seventh, Archbishop of the Ishgardian Orthodox Church. The last bastion of the faith, her walls ever bristling with the sworn swords and spears of her four high houses.
Oh, I see a rose.
A land that after a thousand years of war had forgotten what it was to be at peace.
Aww.
Through gates long closed, the Warrior of Light and her companions passed, entering at last a city whose history was written in blood. In the midst of the Dragon Song War, they came. Three weary travelers whose arrival would set in motion great change. Though none knew then how great.
So goofy. I like the music here. Already went to bed and I'm like I said thank you for coming along with me on this journey, everybody. I appreciate it. It's been fun. It's like you're tapping me on the head. That's funny. Oh my jeez. But yeah, thank you again. It was great. Yeah, there you go. That's so much better. And I like I'm still looking up. Still looking up. Ever looking up. But yeah, it was a nice little distraction on this sad night. I appreciate it. I appreciate everybody's help. I appreciate you hanging out with me and getting me to this point. And now I can start the next journey. But yes, on that lovely note, I'm saying goodnight. So, goodnight, everybody. And until next time, we'll hang out again, I'm sure. Thanks again.